Hello, my name is Aditi Acharya and I am from AISS MS IoIT BEA division. Today I am going to give a presentation on machine learning. So the points that I am going to cover in this presentation are: first, I'll explain what least square method is, then I'll explain what is line of best fit, how to calculate this line of best fit, then I'll explain an example on how to use least square method, and then I'll move on and explain KNN or k nearest neighbor algorithm, and then I'll end this presentation with an example of classification KNN and regression KNN. So let's start. What is least square method? Now, least square regression method is a technique which is commonly used in regression analysis. We already know that regression is a very common type of problem in machine learning. It falls under supervised learning. Least square method is a mathematical method which is used to find the best fit line that represents the relationship between two variables. One is an independent variable and the other is a dependent one. Now, to understand least square method better, we should first understand what is this line of best fit, because this is the most important part of least square method. So let us understand what is line of best fit. Line of best fit is a line which is drawn across scatter plot of data points in order to represent a relationship between those data points. So in simple words, we can say that a line of best fit will represent a relationship between two or more variables. Now, this is what is done in regression. In regression analysis, we make use of mathematical methods such as least square method in order to get a refinite relationship between your predictor and your target variable. Least square method is one of the best and one of the most effective ways in which you can draw a line of best fit. It is based on the idea that the square of errors obtained must be minimized to the most possible extent, and hence it is named as least square method. Now, to understand line of best fit better, let us see this example. Now, suppose I want to plot a line of best fit which shows the relationship between sales of ice cream and temperature. It would look something like this. The temperature which is shown on the x-axis is your independent variable, and the sales of ice cream which is shown on the y-axis is your dependent variable. Now, we all know that sales of ice cream always depends on the temperature. The higher or the hotter the temperature, the more will be the sales of ice cream, and the lesser or the colder the temperature, the less will be the sales of ice cream. Now, while drawing the line of best fit, you should always keep in mind that this line of best fit should be drawn as close to the data point as possible. This is done in order to minimize error. Now, what is an error? Error is basically the difference between actual and the predicted value. This error can also be called as residual. So, in this figure, you can see that the orange circles represent your actual values, and the predicted values are the ones which are plotted on the line of best fit. An error is the difference between the two of them. Now, why do we need to calculate this error? This error is calculated to find distance to the line. And distance to the line is the summation of all of the squares of these errors. As you can see in this slide, distance to the line, which is represented as capital D, is equal to the sum of all of these errors. Now, in least square method, we choose the model which has minimum value of distance to the line, which means that it has minimum error. So let's consider these two models. In the first model, you can see that the distance to the line will be greater because the error is larger, and in the second model, the distance to the line will be lesser because the error is lesser. So you can compare these two models and easily say that the second model is a better model to predict your sales of ice cream, because it will give you more accurate results as compared to the first one. And this is what is done in machine learning. You create many such line of best fit and create many such models until you get the one which gives you least error. So now that we've understood what is line of best fit and why do we need it, let us see how to calculate this line of best fit. So, Look at this equation, y is equal to mx plus c. We have all come across this equation before. It is a simple equation which represents a line, a straight line along two-dimensional data, which is x-axis and y-axis. Y represents your dependent variable, x represents independent variable, m is the slope of the line, and c is the y-intercept. Now, if we consider the example that I had shown you earlier of the sales of ice cream, there x would have been temperature because it was your independent variable, and y would have been sales of ice cream because it was your dependent variable. Now, x is commonly known as your predictor variable because it helps you predict a y variable, and y is the target variable which you have to predict. Now, there are various steps involved to calculate line of best fit. There are three steps. We'll look at all of them one by one in detail. So the step one is to calculate m, that is your slope of the line. Now you can calculate m using the formula which is shown on the screen. All you have to do is substitute the value of x and y in this equation and you will get m. M here will be the total number of data points. So suppose if I have 5 data points, then n will be equal to 5. I substitute all of these values in this equation and I'll get slope of the line. The second step is to calculate the y-intercept. Now for those of you who don't know, y-intercept is the point on the line that meets your y-axis, as you can see in this figure. Now calculating y-intercept is also easy. All you have to do is substitute the values of x, y and m in this equation, c equal to y minus x, and you will get your y-intercept. Now the third and the final step to calculate line of best fit is substituting all of the values in the final equation. The final equation is y equal to mx plus c. So you substitute the values that you've got in your step 1 and step 2 in this equation, and you get your line of best fit. Now that we've seen how to calculate line of best fit, we'll look at an example and understand how this line of best fit helps us make predictions. Now in this example, Tom is an owner of a retail shop and he has found the price of different t-shirts versus the number of t-shirts sold at his shop over a period of 1 week. So the price of t-shirts, which are in dollars, is your x variable, and the number of t-shirts sold is your y variable, and the values of these variables are given in a table. So let us calculate the line of best fit. So the step one to calculate line of best fit is to calculate your slope m. So now we have the values of x and y, and we also have the value of n, which is equal to 5 because we have 5 data points in total. So we'll substitute all of these values in the equation and we get m equal to 1.518 approximately. The second step is to compute the y-intercept. So substitute the value of m that you've got from your step 1, substitute the values of x and y, and you will get c equal to 0.305. The final step is to substitute the values of m and c that you've got from step 1 and step 2 in your final equation, and you get the equation y equal to 1.518x plus 0.305. Now this is your line of best fit. Now suppose that Tom wants to find out how many t-shirts of price $8 he can sell at this retail shop. So here now your x is equal to $8. So to find out how many t-shirts he can sell, all you have to do is substitute x equal to 8 in your final equation and you get y equal to 12.45, which is basically 13 t-shirts. So this means that if Tom starts selling a new t-shirt of $8, he will sell around 13 such t-shirts. So this is how you use regression to make predictions. So let's summarize what we've learned in least square method. Least square method works by minimizing the sum of squares of the errors to as small as possible, and that is why it is named as least square method. The data must be free of outliers. Now, what are outliers? Outliers are the points that deviate significantly from the rest of the data points. They can be caused by measurement or execution error. So outliers are the points that are wrong or that are error points, and you must not include them while performing any algorithm. Line of best fit can be drawn multiple times until you get a line with minimum possible square of errors. And least square method works perfectly with non-linear data as well. Now the next algorithm is KNN or K-nearest neighbor algorithm. So KNN or K-nearest neighbor is one of the simplest supervised machine learning algorithm, and it is mostly used for classification. It classifies a data point based on how its neighbors are classified. KNN algorithm can also be used for regression, but it is mostly used for classification. KNN is called a lazy learning algorithm. This is because it doesn't learn from a discriminative function from the training data, but it actually memorizes the training data set. This means that KNN stores all available cases and classifies new cases based on similarity. KNN is a wonderful algorithm if you want to solve for a non-linear classified data points. This means that if your data points are distributed in a non-linear manner, we cannot draw a straight line and classify those data points as we do in least square method. So here is when KNN method is useful. So while using KNN method, you have to actually calculate the distance between data points, and this is done using two formulas. One is Euclidean distance formula and the second is Manhattan distance formula. Let us see how to calculate distance using both of them. So suppose if I want to calculate distance d, which is shown in this figure, from x1 to y1 and x2 to y2, all I have to do is draw a right angled triangle and then use this formula. Euclidean distance is equal to under root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. And Manhattan distance will be equal to mod of x2 minus x1 plus mod of y2 minus y1. Now that we've understood what is KNN, let us look at an example of classification use case. So in KNN, we have to select a K value. K value indicates that how many nearest neighbors you have to consider in terms of distance. We will see later on in this presentation how to select value of K. But for this example, let us consider that K is equal to 5. So this means that I will consider 5 nearest neighbors to my unknown data point to classify this data point. So as you can see in the figure, my unknown data point which I have to classify is shown with white color. And there are two different classes, one is yellow category and second is green category. Now the 5 nearest neighbors to my unknown data point are 3 yellow and 2 green. So now classification use case of KNN works on similarity. So majority wins here. This means that my unknown data point has more features similar to the yellow category and lesser features similar to the green category. So I will classify my unknown white data point as yellow. Now let us see an example of regression use case. Now in regression, I do not have two classes. So how do we classify my unknown data point? Now here also let us consider that K is equal to 5. So in regression, we actually calculate the mean of all of the nearest neighbors, and the mean value will be equal to the value of the new data point. So we've seen an example of classification regression of KNN. It is very simple. Now let us see how to calculate the value of K. So K will be equal to the square root of n, where n is the total number of data points. And you should always remember that the value of K should be an odd value. This is done in order to avoid confusion. This means that suppose in the previous example of classification use case, if I would have chosen my K equal to 6, and the six nearest neighbors to my unknown data point would have been three yellow and three green neighbors, it would have been very difficult for me to classify my unknown data point because the similarity would have been equal in both of the cases. And hence, it is always advised to use an odd value for k. The higher the value of k, the lesser the chances of an error. Now, let us summarize what we've learned in k-nearest neighbor. KNN or k-nearest neighbor classifies the data points based on how its neighbors are classified. The data points must be free of outliers. KNN algorithm can be used for regression problems, but it is mostly used for classification problems. And you should always remember to choose an odd value for k. Thank you. This is the end of the presentation. I hope you've understood what is least square method and k-nearest neighbor method. Thank you.